clean is the way that you're making me feel tonight. It's hard to let it go. Hello everyone, I'm Daxani, and I am so excited for Kingdom Hearts 3, who's with me? Oh my gosh, it's been, what, 10,000 years? And now we're finally getting Kingdom Hearts 3? Well, maybe I'm over-exaggerating here, but it's actually been about 19 years, but bruh, oh my King Mickey, that's still a long time. I was getting a bit fed up with Square Enix at first because they kept pushing the release date back for Kingdom Hearts 3. I went to the D23 Expo in 2017, which is basically the Disney Expo, and you know, they said the release was going to be in 2018. Then 2018 came, it was set for November, then possibly December, and now we have a final release date, which is 2019, January 29th. Of course, it would be at the end of the month. But you know what? It's here in like a few minutes, basically. That's what it feels like. And I'm ready for it. I'm here for it. I'm ready. I pre-ordered the game through Amazon, and supposedly there's a really, really tiny chance that I may get it a day before, but who knows, you know? But as long as I get my game, I'm all good, you know? So I'm just gonna sit right there by the mailbox and wait for Mr. Mailman or Mailwoman to come and, you know, we're all Gucci. It's good. It's good, fam. I've only seen 2 trailers of the game, and I kept it that way on purpose because Square Enix was just putting out a vomit load of trailers and sneak peeks, and low-key, I was getting annoyed because when I play this game, I want to be surprised. I want to be shocked. I want to be stupefied. Don't spoil me and tease me with all that Kingdom Hearts sneak peek and, you know, oh my gosh. Like, it was just too much, and I was like, no, I want the experience when I actually play this game, you know? But, yeah, I'm ready. And, also, just to let you all know, for those of you who have subscribed to me, and, you know, thank you guys so much, but when Kingdom Hearts comes out, I will be occupied. I will possibly going MIA, until I finish this game. Just to let you guys know, so, you know, yeah. Well, in honor of Kingdom Hearts 3, I wanted to draw Aqua. I drew the version of her, basically, you know, she's already consumed by darkness, and which is really sad, because, you know, that's the homegirl. Like, you know, I can't wait to bring her back to the light. That's my girl. Don't worry, Aqua, I'm coming for you. I'm gonna help you. I will save you from the darkness. Okay, so I don't know if you guys noticed during the sketching process how much I struggled with the hair. I kept deleting it and redrawing it, trying to perfect it, but it just wasn't coming out right. Like, even the final hair that you see right now, I'm still not slightly okay, but it was better than what I was initially drawing in the beginning. So this was probably the closest to spiky hair that I could do, and I strayed away from anime style hair maybe sometime in high school. You know, most people who draw, you know, they reference their art based on anime style, and I haven't done that in years. So kind of going back to it, I had flashbacks, and I was just like, man, this is hard. Also, like, her face shape, I changed it, because to me, like, in the beginning, it just wasn't coming out right. It looked a little bit too round, and it wasn't really narrow, and I guess there wasn't really a sharp facial structure, which she tends to have in my eyes. So I went back and I fixed it, and I'm happy that I made that change. But honestly, this took about maybe 3 to 4 hours. This was very tedious, but I'm not gonna lie, I loved how it came out. I know probably sometime in the future when I develop more and more as I grow as an artist, maybe I'll come back to this and I'll redraw it, and it'll look much better than it does now, like, for sure. The armor the armor was fun, actually. I kind of cringed at the armor. You know, at the thought that, like, man, I'm going to draw it. I don't have to, but I want to. But it was actually easy. I mean, I think I could have done more with it, but that's all I really ended up doing. As for, like, the little, the star keychains that, you know, that she has one for herself and she gives to Ventus and Terra, those, I thought it would be, I guess, complicated, but it was actually enjoyable to do. And because, like, honestly, I kind of stress out when it's like, objects. I hate doing objects. But this one was really nice. Like, I had a good experience with this, with drawing the stars, the little keychains that she gives to them to honor their friendship. And yeah, I loved how they came out. They're a little bit, I guess, lopsided, but, you know, I don't know, I just couldn't get the dimensions right or something, but for the most part, I think they came out pretty decent. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this drawing. Thanks for listening, thanks for watching, and if you guys are playing Kingdom Hearts this week, have fun, good luck fighting all those Heartless out there, and let's save Aqua, and let's restore all of the worlds again. High five to everybody, I love you, and I shall chat with you guys soon. Bye! Let me face my fears.